on, Martin. Come on, we all got the horse, come on.
In the town of Thurles, in the county of Tipperary, Irish traveller Barry lives with his wife and six children in a caravan on the side of a bridge.
Hold in for the horse, good girl.
Along with eight other traveller families and around 30 horses, Barry has lived on the bridge all his life.
The boys are back from the jog there. They're just back from the jog with the horses, yeah.
There's one part of traveller culture at the heart of life on the bridge.
Generations and generations of my people, they kept horses all their lives. That's our tradition, like. They're part of the family.
Barry's way of life on the bridge has recently changed, as the council have built six detached houses, costing £1.7 million for them to move into.
These are the houses that they've done, and it's a lovely project.
But, frustratingly for the travellers, the houses were completed with no room for their beloved horses, despite, they say, an agreement with the council.
So now the contract is done. It costs £1.7 million. And they're not giving us no land for horses. They're the ones that pressured us to go for these houses, and they give us the land that they promised us, and it never happened.
To make matters worse, the travellers' decision has attracted a media storm, after Irish presidential candidate Peter Casey criticised them in the press.
They want stables for the houses and an acre of land. I mean, how many people in... it's just
so
silly.
But they do have horses, as we can see.
Yeah.
Controversially, Casey used the situation to take aim at the whole of the travelling community.
Why should they be given status over and above yourself or myself?
They are seen as a minority ethnicity.
That's a load of nonsense. You know, they're not from Romania here. They're basically people that are camping on somebody else's land.
Casey's comments, along with the news of the unwanted houses, is causing even more conflict between travellers and settled people.
I think that there's two sides to that story, and one side is not being heard at all. That's the side of the travellers' community.
We're quite happy to live where we want. We didn't need houses. A house really never bothered me, I'll be honest about it. Stand there and hold them like that there and put your two hands in the loose.
I like riding horses now. The best part of living here is we have our own property. We don't have to be bossed around and put it anywhere. We could tie a horse anywhere.
Hold the reins, pet.
But...
She hold them. She's 2 years old. And ever since she started walking, she's mad for horses. When I yoke up down the gate, she... A horse keeps them right, keeps them out of trouble, keeps them from the towns, so getting into hassle and stuff. We couldn't afford to do without our horses and do that to our family as well, I'll be honest about it. We could not do it.
The controversy surrounding the story has soured the relationship between Barry's family and their settled neighbours.
The atmosphere is completely changed. This whole thing is turned with our neighbours against us. Running us down very bad, I'll be honest about it, you know.
Even Barry's eldest daughter, Eleanor, has felt the effect.
At school, you can tell the people talking about you and you want to stand up for yourself, but you actually can't. You'd say something, but you wouldn't want to be mean about it either to make them upset. I think it's kind of bad.
In an attempt to get their side of the story across to their neighbours, Barry and his family have come up with a solution.
These signs here is up for to show all the people that pass it that we didn't ask for this. We didn't want anything.
They had a traditional way of life and we dragged them out of it. And we didn't provide any way of settling them in our community properly.
Horses is our life. That's not something that came overnight and it's not something that you can throw away the next day. We're not giving it up. We're not giving up our culture. The best way of saying it. We're just not giving it up.